Yes, people, I hope you're all doing well. Welcome back to another YouTube video. We're in for legs, and today's YouTube video isn't just me training legs, because as I said in the first YouTube video that I'd done a few weeks back now, when I kind of made a little return to YouTube, just doing training videos is something that I don't want to do because it gets pretty redundant. So I'm actually gonna show you a little bit of go-karting that I've done with my clients as well over the weekend. But first, I wanted to take you through legs, wanted to take you through the thought process behind what I'm doing. You've seen my other leg day video, which was focused around hamstrings and glutes. This one is more so centered around quads. So the main movement today is gonna be a quad movement, which is the beautiful, beautiful Cybex hack. Oh man, that hack squat is amazing. If you know, you know. But at the start of leg day, as always, we got some calf raises just standing again. This is the only calf raise machine that the coach has, but in the new unit that my man Nathaniel's gonna get, he'll also have a seated calf raise as well. And seated is also good to do because it trains another muscle in your calf. So if you can get both seated and standing, perfect. So yeah, started off with a standing calf raise, and then we moved on to the adductor. Oh no, not the adductor, fucking hell. The seated hamstring curl machine. And as you can see here, I'm actually buckling in using a seat belt, and what that does, it just provides a little bit more stability. If you don't have the seat belt, you slide a little bit more, you're less glued to the machine as per se, whereas if you have the seat belt, you can really lock in. And look how much it shows my stomach, fucking hell. But yeah, so I've done two sets on the seated ham curl. This ham curl is amazing, it's Cybex. I'm gonna let you watch the end of the set. Just two sets on that. First set was a little bit more aggressive than the second set. The second set on that movement, I do a little 2 second pause on the contraction with a lighter weight, and then we moved on to the adductor. As mentioned in my other leg day video, I push the seat back just because of my mobility. It allows me to get into that position nice. If I sit up too, if I'm too upright, I just can't get in the position properly. I'm just way too tight in the hips. This set was a rest pause set. So we done, I believe it was 12 to 15 reps. I can't remember the exact amount of reps I've done with it. But we done a rest pause. So we done reps until failure. I waited 20 seconds. Then I done as many reps as I could straight after that. So you'll see that there, and what that does is it basically just makes the set a little bit more intense. It increases the amount of work you're doing on the adductors. So rather than you just doing two straight sets, you've added in another element to that set, which makes it tougher, and it also means you do more work, which is obviously the goal for me and my legs. We need them to grow. So so you can see here, setting up again. The setup was quite hard, but get into position, go straight back to it. I've only rested 20 seconds. And then just finish the job. And then we moved on to the main event, probably my favorite machine in the gym of all time, the Cybex hack. And I've recently made a little change where I've taken off the band, because all you little band bandits have got into my head about reverse banding, and I don't know why you got into my head, because I never let people get into my head about training. I usually just do my own thing and get on with it, but people talking about bands, all this shit, I was like, do you know what, let me take off the band. Because I've been getting like 6 plates for about 7 or 8 reps with a band. A lot of people believe that if you reverse band things, you you make it a lot easier for yourself. You don't. But anyway, warm-ups were going well. Took off the band and we went for 6 plates on the working set.
Okay. Let's get it, boyo. Okay. Okay, come on. Let's get it. Let's get it. all the moves. Yep. Yep. Halfway. Come on, you got more. Come on, come on. And this, ladies and gentlemen, is how you spot.
I've gone more conservative because of my back.
But it's the back off. Come on. No?
It's got, I'm going to go for at least 20.
I want at least 20. I swear you're not leaving this without, I'll put my leg, my foot on that fucking handle so you can't bring it up. Let's work.
So yeah, 6 plates, boy, on that Cyrex hack. Then we went straight to the pivot leg press or the squat press. Again, incredible machine for your quads. Keep the feet nice and low and get as low as you possibly can, but within your active range. I got hurt on this machine last week, which is why I moved a little bit more conservatively. Went for 6 plates, but I was aiming for more than 20 reps. So when you're injured and you've got injuries, you need to know when to back off, when to not take the piss. So go high rep, the risk is low, you've got more control of the weight, and you can still create that stimulus that's needed to grow muscle. We know from research that the response you're getting from 6 reps and the response you get from 30 reps is exactly the same in terms of muscle growth. Rep ranges are more so there just for enjoyment and injury management prevention. So bear that in mind. Whenever you're going in with a niggle, drop the weight. Reach failure with something a little bit safer. So yeah, this was just one set on here as well. I took the volume down from 2 sets to just 1. And then on the hack squat, I also only done 1 set as well. 6 plates for 6 reps on my own, and then some help on that 7th rep. So yeah, they both felt absolutely incredible.
Good. 4. Good. Keep going. Keep going. Continuous. You got them. Come on. Come on. 4 left. Yeah, you know the rule. You know the rule. Let's go.
Come on.
4 left. Continuous and you're done. Go. 3. Go. 2. Go. One more. Straight up. Drive.
Pain. And then we finish on the leg extension. And again, kind of placing that leg extension towards the end of this session just to manage the knees. I've put a lot of work through my quads at this point, and I can use less weight on this leg extension and still get the stimulus that's needed. And this was 2 sets, an absolutely disgusting machine. Loads a lot in that stretch and then drops off at the top on that extension. Very similar feeling to the prime leg extension. But yeah, really, really nice piece of kit. And then after the leg extension, I actually finished on some Bulgarian split squats. Contralateral, which basically just means I'm loading on the opposite side, so on the opposite side of my body. So let's say I'm working my right leg. I'm gonna hold the dumbbell in my left hand. Rather than holding 2, it kind of just helps the balance and just helps the stability as well. So you'll see that in a second. So holding it in my right hand, working my left leg. The stretch on this is really nice as well on the other leg. But yeah, that's pretty much the workout. The next thing you'll see will actually be the little vlog from karting with a few of my clients, which was incredible. So much fun. I haven't been karting since I was so young, but yeah, I hope you guys found this leg day training useful, the commentary useful. Any questions, just drop them in the comments, and I'll see you in a bit.
Come on, Elliot. Come on. Come on. Get it. These are the ones. These are the ones. We're here for that. Get it. Big push.
Good.
Yeah.
You're recording, yeah? Hi guys, welcome back to another video. Yesterday, no, Friday, I recorded legs. So you're gonna see that video as well. You've seen one of the leg videos or leg training sessions, which is my RDL session. This one on Friday was my quad one. But yeah, and I do a little commentary over that and talk about the movement. But right now we're on our way to go-karting with some of the clients. And I'm actually gonna meet some clients that I've never even seen before. A little bit concerned because the last time I went go-karting, I probably weighed about 72 kilos. And now, and literally I'm at 116. I actually had to call the place and be like, by the way, somebody who's coming is over 114 kilos.
Did you say somebody that's coming?
Like, they were like, is it you, mate? I was like, yeah, it's me. They're like, you should be okay. It's more just if you can like reach the steering wheel. So yeah, we've got to be there for 10:30. We'll get a little induction and go from there. We basically do 10 lap time trial, and then we've got a race at the end. So I don't think it'd be too long. I think it'll only be like an hour and a half. I just kind of want to vlog whatever I can of it and then go.
Apparently I'm going to be the slowest.
Alright guys, so it's the next day. Karting yesterday was sick. The second little event that I've actually done with a few of my clients. Big goal of mine really this year was to kind of build a better community and just a larger community with my clients. And yeah, enjoyable. And obviously your boy had to get first place. I feel like my body weight held me back a little bit in terms of just being faster, but nonetheless we smashed it. It was great, great fun. And everyone seemed to enjoy it, so. But yeah guys, I hope you enjoyed the video this week. Subscribe to the channel and I'll see you soon.